How has social media affected journalism?
Oh, man.
Where do I get started?
I know. Where do I start? I mean, I try not to be so pessimistic about it, but it's drastically changed our profession. The media was never perfect, but I came up as a journalist when there wasn't social media, and there was a shame that went along with getting something wrong about somebody you were writing about, whether it be their name, a fact. Like, you were embarrassed when that happened because you couldn't just go online and correct it. The paper had to run a full-scale correction the next day, so you had to live with that mistake being there in that edition's paper. And so now there's not a lot of accountability. We're in the age of corporate media. The size of the media is shrinking, and it's owned by fewer people. And as a result, they are trying to turn media and journalism into a for-profit business. And much like any other businesses, they're trying to make as much money as possible, as cheaply as possible, and it's affected the product. It's not a lot of mainstream media outlets that can be committed from a financial standpoint to really doing good journalism. And that's why you see some of the mistakes you see, some of the stories that get written that are a little more salacious. There are things now that are able to be printed and tweeted and all that kind of thing that would never have stood 20 years ago. There's a rush to be first and not right.
Right. That's my main thing, being first and right.
Yeah, they are good with being first and wrong, and because there's really no repercussions for it, right? And so that part greatly concerns me. The misinformation concerns me. Not to go all conspiracy theory on everybody, but people have to understand with everything we saw in the last election, with Facebook's role in this, social media's role in this, is that most people these days, unlike kind of, I think, probably from the age we were all from, they are looking to reaffirm their beliefs through media as opposed to neutrally being told the information and then coming to a conclusion. You know, it's a reason why certain networks, you know what their political slant is, and that's why they watch it, because they want somebody else to just reinforce what they already think.
Fox News.
If that's... You said it. So if they already think that way, it's like then they're happy to traffic in misinformation. And so I worry about people's ability to decipher what is fake and what is true. A Facebook meme will go around and people will take that as the truth in a minute.
Oh, yeah, no question.
Yeah, I mean, I remember during the Kaepernick stuff when that meme got around about Tim Tebow. Tim Tebow took a knee and nobody did anything. And that totally wasn't what he was doing. He was praying in the end zone, and somebody took the image and said that he was taking a knee for pro-life rights. And it's that people thought that was true. And I saw that hundreds of times. And that's what happens nowadays. One bit of information gets out about you, and if it circulates enough, nobody sticks around to see if it's correct or not.
Oh, we've been labeled like that plenty of
times. Yeah, I was like, I know I'm preaching to the choir over here.
Being a leader in the industry, what kind of challenges have come with that? Being a black female in this space, but also being a leader.
Well, I think, you know, kind of one of the challenges.
One thing they know, you ain't taking no shit. they know that now. Well, when you walk in that building, you better come correct or don't come at all.
Yeah, I guess I am sort of getting that reputation, but.
That's solid,
hey,
though.
Welcome to the club.
I know, yeah, right? Yeah. No, I mean, I think a lot of the things I've gone through are just relatable to, like, black people everywhere. Being held sometimes to a different standard, being scrutinized differently. You know, certainly when you're a woman in sports, a lot of people think that you're there just to get a husband or, you know, to date somebody. And that's why I hate it, movies, when they always have that storyline of the reporter hooking up with the athlete. It's so annoying. I'm like, that's not what we're all in there for. So I'm not saying it has never happened. What I am saying is, like, that's really not the mission. So, you know, you just have to live with the fact that you'll be doubted, that they're going to come at you a different way than they would a man. You know, people seem to think that sports knowledge is directly related to genitalia, and it doesn't work that way. So those are, you know, dealing with those doubts are something that I feel like most black people experience regardless of what your, you know, profession is. But it can be doubly worse when you're a black woman, because you then have to deal with the narrative that we're angry, combative. If we assert ourselves, it's viewed totally different than if a white dude does it.
Gabby faced that. Gabrielle Union faced the whole
totally
thing.
Totally did. It's like, okay, she stood up for something that, frankly, anybody should have stood up for.
But she's labeled as a
But now she's a troublemaker. Now she's difficult. And so, you know, we have to deal with, or I've certainly had to deal with some of that, you know, as well. And it does get taxing. It is, some days, you know, you wonder how much fight you have left in you. But for me, what always keeps me going, and this is that leadership part that comes with it, this isn't about me anymore. It has ceased to be about me for a long time. This is about the younger journalists of color who are looking at me. And yeah, it's about who's next. And it's not just about me getting them through the door. I have to make through when they get through the door, it's a safe place for them. And so I can't be at work anymore and work in environments where I can't not just speak my mind, but I can't get them to culture correct if there's a problem. So, I mean, that's kind of all that I'm in it for. And because, again, the numbers look real sad. And it's changing how the news and how we as a culture and community are perceived when you have a number of journalists who do not look like you covering people that they have really no connection or contact with or have never had any. It greatly changes how they're perceived.